one, say one for me. The next time you pray one for me. And you have my promise, I'll say one for you. The next best thing to one prayer is two.
The next time you're wishing, just wish one more. And let's keep a thought for each other.
Your brightest star will brighter be if the next time you say one,
you kneel down to pray one,
you'll remember to say one for me. The next.
Everyone's racing around in a tizzy.
One.
Hurry and hurry and
say one for me.
It's discouraging.
The next.
No one's relaxing because everyone's busy.
One.
Worrying, worrying.
Pray one for me.
It's discouraging.
And you have my promise.
Promises, promises.
I'll say one for you.
Promises, promises, promises.
The next best thing to one prayer,
I know,
is two.
How true.
How true.
May I tell you something?
The next.
Nobody's taking the time to be kindly scurrying, scurrying.
Just wish one more.
I'm a pessimist.
And let's keep a thought for each other.
Each other.
Your brightest star will brighter be
if the next time you say one,
you kneel down to pray one,
you remember to say one
for me.
Oh, Holly, you dance like that tonight at the benefit, and you're going to be a big success in your debut.
Oh, well, I hope so. Every time I think about an audience out here, I start getting butterflies.
Oh, all performers get butterflies, Holly.
But mine feel like they're wearing army shoes, Father.
Now, don't you worry about it. I tell you, you're going to be all right, Holly. Now, everybody gets a little self-conscious the first time in front of an audience, so you just look out there and pick out a friendly face. And then you simply play to that person. An elderly priest gave me this tip, just before I delivered my first sermon.
Okay, you be my friendly face at the benefit, and I'll be your friendly face at church tonight.
Promises, promises, promises.
Goodbye, Father.
Goodbye. exalts himself shall be humbled, and he who humbles himself shall be exalted.
The end of the Holy Gospel.
I should like to say a few words this morning about a very holy obligation, regular attendance at Mass. When I first came to this parish some years back and observed the special needs of you people living and working here in the theatrical district, I inaugurated the practice of saying Mass at 2 o'clock in the morning. Sad to relate, patronage has been a bit light. I just wanted to say, if you run into any of the missing members, you tell them that Father Conroy will be very glad to see them at his late, late, late show.
Good night, Father.
Good night, showstopper. That was a great idea of yours, Harry, having Holly break in on a benefit.
Whose idea?
Well, I guess it was really my idea. But you'd have been proud of me, Dad. I was a big hit, wasn't I, Father Conroy?
I'd be a lot prouder of you if you were a big hit at college.
College?
No, I'm knocking myself out doing 5 shows a day so she can graduate. One entertainer in the family is enough. Hmm? I want her to go to those daytime masses. You've heard of those, Father.
Oh, I broke in on them.
Oh, don't forget, you're coming to see her graduate.
I wouldn't miss it for the world.
Thanks, Father.
Good night, Father.
Good foggy night.
Now, look, have you looked at this guy? Let me take your pencil.
Oh, here. There's an orphanage uptown needs a little help. I was wondering if...
Father. You want me to get you 5 acts and a piano player for Saturday night?
Well, if a piano player could sing, 4 acts would be.
I got just the act.
Fella? Yeah. Prunes a little?
Oh, prunes
Irish
a little.
Irish tenor?
Yeah, out of Tacoma.
Out of Tacoma, huh?
Yeah, nice kid. You'll like it.
Good.
Well, I gotta beat it now. I gotta get back to the club. I'm stuck in a poker game. Good night, Father.
If it isn't poker with Jim, it's something else. He'd probably be very happy if I'd announced the race results from the pulpit every morning.
Remember when I jailed that bookmaker of his last summer?
Yeah.
And Jim wanted me to go down to the station and place his bets for him.
Lou, I got an item for your column.
All right, Father.
Jim is getting an act together. He wants to stage a little comeback.
Oh, I can't use that, Father. This generation never heard of him.
That's because they've never read of him, Lou.
Okay, Father.
He'll appreciate it.
All right, Father.
Good night, fellas.
Good night, Father.
Hey, Father.
I know you're not a drinking man, but this is belonging around the bar gathering dust.
Benedictine.
Yeah, we never get a call for this fancy liqueur. And, compliments from Otto's Bar and Grill.
Sounds like you're having a lively night over there tonight.
Yeah, they're running me ragged. The jukebox blasting. You know, I wish I would have listened to my mother and become a priest instead of a bartender. The hours are better and I wouldn't have to listen to so many confessions.
But your memoirs will be priceless, Otto.
Good night, Father.
Father, why don't you get some sleep?
Oh, Mary, you know if I nap between the 2 o'clock and the 6 o'clock mass, it makes me drowsy. That's a tough audience. I don't want to fall asleep during my sermon. It's a gift from one of the neighbors.
I know it's none of my business, but...
Mary, you know, if everything you say is none of your business was none of your business, conversationally, we'd be out of business around here. What is it this time?
It's those actors, the nightclub characters. Saving those souls is one thing, Father, but hanging around with them on street corners at 3 o'clock in the morning, no wonder they're taking such a sacrilegious attitude towards you.
Sacrilegious?
Well, treating you like you was one of them, taking you off to the prize fights, and using our basement as a rehearsal hall. And now bringing your whiskey? But the next thing you know, they'll be asking you to judge one of them beauty contests.
Well, Mary, if it comes to that, we'll rig it so you win the cup. And Mary... This isn't whiskey. It's a fine after-dinner cordial, and we should bless the hands that made it.
Well, it seems to me if I was a priest, I'd be too busy tying knots in the devil's tail to have time for blessing a lot of bootleggers.
Bootleggers? No, this is Benedictine. Look, Mary, it's made by the Benedictine monks.
Well, somebody ought to tell the Pope.
It's St. Joseph's Parish.
You never know it.
Yes, it's Father Conroy speaking. I'll be right over. Don't wait up for me.
Where to at this time of night?
Oh,
Holly.
Oh, Father.
How is he?
And the doctor's with him now. You know, it's so sudden. You saw him tonight, and they said his collapse was brought on by exhaustion. They said he has a damaged artery. Oh, Dr. Leventhal, this is Father Conroy.
We met before. We've worked together.
Hello, Father. Now, your father's illness is serious, but not critical. But I'm not sure that he believes me. He's badly frightened. I think he'd like to see you, Father.
Hello, Mary. Glad you're here, Father. Doctor says you're going to be all right.
I hope so. Not for myself so much, but for the kid. Of all she's got since she was 10. With Martha gone, I had to play a dual role.
A magnificent performance you've given, too.
Holly gave me this ring when she was 16.
It's nice.
She gave it to me for Mother's Day.
Harry, you know, I think it's time you were slipping back into that motherly role. Mothers don't frighten easy, you know.
It isn't frightened so much, Father. Worried. I may be out of action for a long time. There's no money. Kid needs someone to look after her.
Don't you worry. Somebody will.
My special lyrics.
Keep it up and you'll have me on the bottle.
Thanks.
Hi, Phil.
Got your contracts all signed.
You get the loot I wanted?
Right. 4 weeks guarantee.
And 10% of the net for putting on the show?
Right. Got the details all ironed out.
Yeah, well, you ought to get that suit ironed up. Some agent. He drinks and you look it.
Ready to inspect the merchandise?
Yeah. Have them line up for inventory.
All right, kids, front and center.
What's your name?
Don Easter.
Don Easter. What's your real name?
Please, mister, it ain't as good as Don Easter.
How old are you, Don?
21.
What year were you born in? Quick.
I'm 21. Can't you count?
Yeah, I can count. Let me see your ID card.
I lost it.
I'll give you time to find it. Say about 5 years, okay?
Oh, but I want to be in the show.
Look, baby, I can't have a doll as young as you working around here. It's against my principles. Besides, you could get some poor guy arrested. Now, look, come back in 5 years, like I said, and I'll give you a job, okay?
In this crummy joint? Why, in 5 months, I'll be a star.
Come here. Come on. No rehearsal clothes?
I wore a bathing suit.
Well, come on, come on. Okay, okay. I'm through counting. Come on. If you ever decide to swim the channel, I'd like to handle the grease job. What's your name?
Holly.
Holly? Holly what?
Holly Conroy.
Had any experience, Conroy?
Well, I can dance and I can sing.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you sing?
Mostly in college.
College, huh? We got a guy here who went to college. And you know something? He works for me. Knock it off. Princeton man. Graduated. Magna cum laude. Understand? Hey, Phil. The kid says she can sing. See if she can cut that, will you?
He forgets the social graces. I'm Phil Stanley.
Holly LeMaise.
No, you're not. Holly Conroy.
Okay, girls, relax. Take it easy.
You're not going to hire that kid, are you?
Why not? She's not too young.
She doesn't fit in. She's different.
That's it. That fresh schoolgirl look. You know how many guys she'll bring into this joint? Ain't I got a percentage deal? Ain't I supposed to come up with entertainment that'll attract the customers? That's show business, baby.
You're in show business like Jesse James was in banking.
Oh, great material. Oh. You ready?
Well, we'll see if we can find a mutual key. What's your top note, honey?
I'm not sure.
We'll find your key.
What's my key?
If I could guess that good, I'd be at the racetrack.
Oh, yeah? Well, start guessing, Rum-Dum. Cool it, baby.
I'll start it off, then we'll get together.
You can't love them all. You can't love them all. The thought may be wonderful, but the chances are small. You can't land each one that passes by, but you can try. You can try. You can try.
You can't kiss them all. You can't kiss them all. The ones who have tried have found that they're not quite that tall.
They'll call you an optimistic dope, but you can hope. You can hope. You can hope. They've been able to prove there are mountains that you can move.
They've been able to show there's a way to make rain and snow.
But you simply can't love them all. You can't love them all. 'Cause one day that one girl will catch your eye, and you'll know why. You'll know why. You'll know why.
Hello, doll.
Hello, doll. You can't hug 'em all. You can't hug 'em all. You'll get lots of pictures framed, but you'll run out of wall.
The most you can hope for is a tie. But you can try. You can try. You can try.
You still are gonna find you can't love them all. You just cannot love them all.
'Cause one day that one chick will make you sigh,
and you'll know why.
Hello, doll. You'll know why.
Hello, doll.
You'll know why.
Okay, kid, leave your address. I'll pick you up tonight, and we'll talk it over, okay?
If I could be picked up, I wouldn't need a job.
Come on in, watch the last. Hey, will you wait a minute?
Don't be so touchy. Shoo. You got the job.
No strings attached. All right.
No addresses attached?
Not even phone numbers. Skin.
Okay. Thanks very much.
Did you say no strings attached?
That's it. No strings. To land that one, I'm going to need a net.
Thank you, too, for your patronage, ladies and gentlemen. I can assure you that the proceeds will be put to very good use by Sister Teresa at the Sacred Heart. And now, to continue with the show, a very exciting act, the Offbeats.
You are quite a showman, Father.
Oh, Jim, I think I goofed. I should have opened with this act. Get that sock in on early.
Father, Detective Spinelli is upstairs.
Well, why don't you tell him to come on down?
I was afraid. I thought it might be a raid.
What's the matter, Andy? We're disturbing the peace?
Oh, no, Father. Well, we finally located the LeMaise girl. She's dancing in the joint on the west side.
Dancing? Well, she wrote her father she was working as a secretary.
Find the typewriter.
I can't imagine Monsignor Francis Stratford sneaking out without his collar.
Well, I can't either, but then I'm not a Monsignor.
Of course, it's none of my business, but you shouldn't be going out like that.
I'm sneaking out like this out of respect to the cloth.
You remember how awful it was the last time you went out without your collar?
It was the only way to deal with that fella. He was a wife beater.
And a priest beater.
Well, you can't win them all.
I don't see why you have to go out tonight.
Because I promised her dad I'd keep an eye on her.
Well, you won't be the only one.
Coffee.
Beer.
Thank you, ladies of the ensemble. Ladies of the ensemble. I don't know what ensemble means, and they don't know what lady means. And I want to thank the boys in the band. Take a bow, boys. I call them boys. They're really men. They just play like boys. There he is. My accompanist, Phil Stanley. Take a bow, Phil. That's enough. He's real gone. He's so far out there that he's in orbit. The other night during the show, his feet hurt him, so he slipped his shoes off. There's a hole in his sock, and his toe is sticking out. So I go over to him, and I say, do you know there's a hole in your sock, and your toe is sticking out? He says, what? I say, do you know there's a hole in your sock, and your toe is sticking out? He says, no, but hum a few bars, it may come back to me. Hey, Clyde, these are the jokes, huh? Oh, I get it. You're waiting for the broads to come back, huh? They'll be back, they'll be back. Just nurse your beard, Daddy-O. I may get you a date after the show. And now it's my pleasure to introduce a doll who really adds a lot of class to the joint. She has what we call intellectual appeal. Miss Holly Conroy. I want you folks to know that this chick really went to college. You can see, she's very intelligent. And in just the right places. I want to ask you a question, baby.
Yes?
Honey, around here you don't say yes until you hear the question. Did you rehearse the number we're going to do?
Oh, we rehearsed last night. Don't you remember?
Is that what we were doing?
Crazy.
Go, Phil, it's your birthday.
I'm not unique in Latin or French or Greek. And calculus just between us is not my speed. Still, I'm the girl most likely to succeed.
She has no head for studies like science ed.
And frankly, I fail where even the morons lead. Still, I'm the girl most likely to succeed.
Hip, hip, hooray, they shouted. Hip, hip, hooray with glee.
When the little old dean, who's peachy keen, gave this little old scroll to me, I must admit I'm nothing in English lit. They'll teach me to write as soon as I learn to read.
Still, when the folks were told up what a count she rolled up,
I was plat and scrolled up, yes indeed,
as the girl most likely to succeed.
You ought to see my marks in zoology. I can't tell an elephant from a centipede. Still, I'm the girl most likely to succeed.
French art, she claims, is nothing but foreign names.
So I prefer Orphan Annie to André Gide. Still, I'm the girl most likely to succeed.
Hip, hip, hooray, they chanted every fraternity.
When the faculty bowed and me endowed with a summa cum laude degree, most men, I find, don't worry about your mind.
If two and two's four, that's more than she'll ever need.
I've got a new school sweater.
No one wears it better.
And my big block letters guaranteed.
As the girl most likely to succeed.
who is that guy?
Hey, you know that guy?
I thought I did.
Come on, who is he?
Will you let me alone?
Can't you see she's not your type? Or is that the big attraction?
The big attraction is that she's not your type.
She will be when you're through with her.
Much better. Better. Hey, Hal, I want to see you.
I'll be right out.
But Father, suppose that guy...
No, I think it'll be all right, Will. I'll just be a moment. I'd like to see Miss Holly, Conroy?
She's in her dressing room.
Thank you.
Hey. What are you doing back here?
I came to see a young lady.
Yeah, well, you're off limits. Wait outside.
Hello, Father.
Now, just a minute. Holly.
Father? Father? Is this guy your father?
No, he's a priest.
A priest?
Father. Father, there's nothing wrong with me working here.
Why'd you change your name, then?
Well, I didn't mean to use yours, Father. I just had to think of a name fast.
It's a fast name now.
Hold it. Hey, Holly. What's this change in name business?
It's on account of my dad. He wouldn't approve of me working here.
You wrote him you were a secretary.
Father, I had to have a job that would pay more. The kind of help Dad needs is going to take a lot of money.
He misses you.
I write every day.
On my next visit, you want to come along with me?
And you won't tell him I'm in show business?
You aren't.
Hey, don't let him bug you, baby. And remember, after the last show, we got a date with a pizza.
Sorry, I can't make it.
How do you like that, huh?
Give me a cigarette, will you? Get her all set up and that padre has to bust in and shoot me down in flames.
Tony, you have your pick of a dozen dames. She's a nice church-going mouse working here to help her old man. Give her a break.
Give her a break. I'm throwing myself at her feet. What gives?
A mismatch. In yonder miss, methinks I see the Lady Elaine.
Elaine?
Elaine. And you, my friend, are no knight in shining armor.
Trouble is, she's wearing the armor. I couldn't stand to see anyone go to bed without a pizza. Got it across the street. Still steaming.
How did you know where I live?
Oh. Your address was on this letter I found over at the club.
Found it? That letter was in my purse.
Yeah, that's where I found it.
Attached.
If this pizza's the least bit stringy back, it goes. Now relax. All we're gonna do is eat a pizza.
Is that all?
What else can you do with a pizza? Huh? I get it. Hold
it. It's kind of tricky, you know how?
Why a nickel for every one of these that I've lived in a lot of these joints.
Good for the resistance. Breaks it down.
You don't want this to get cold.
I'm not hungry.
You know, this is too much for me to eat alone.
So, we'll save some for breakfast. Heat it in the oven, nice big cup of coffee. It's terrific.
I'm not hungry either.
Honey, I gotta sleep someplace. I blew my cab fare on the wine. I got a lot of faults, but I never take money from women.
Even if I've earned it.
Save your money, baby. Tonight's a free ride.
Tony, I don't want to be kissed.
Take it easy, baby. We got to start someplace.
You might think of my reputation.
I'm thinking of mine.
No. Tony, I'm afraid.
Some dolls are so afraid of hitting themselves in the morning that they wind up hitting themselves every night.
Well, I'm afraid of the landlady next door. See, I lost my key and I had to wake her up to let me in.
Oh?
She may still be awake. Shh. Quiet. Let me hang up your things. I can't stand a messy bedroom. Shoes and put them in the closet,
I found your letter in your purse. I also found your key. Look, Dal, I'm a guy who always gets what he came for. Remember, Rehearsals at 3 o'clock. Good night, Elaine.
What is it, Mary?
Father, it's him from TV, Monsignor Francis Stratford. He's here in person to see you in person.
Monsignor, you honor us by coming here.
Oh, the honor's mine. You know, I should have visited you long ago, Father. Being in television, I meet a lot of theatrical people, and so many of them talk about you that, well, not knowing you has proved a source of embarrassment to me.
Oh, you flatter me. This is Miss LeMaise, Monsignor. She's the daughter of the chap I wrote to you about.
How do you do?
Won't you come in the study and sit down?
The tea already, Father.
Fine, fine.
I'll help. Yeah. Pictures of your congregation, Father?
Yes, sir.
Most interesting. Who is this?
That's me.
In tights?
Well, yes, you see, I was visiting the Flying Alexanders once while they were rehearsing, and they knew how fascinated I was with their work, so they let me take a swing or two on the trapeze.
Yes, you look most lean and fit, Father.
Well, that was taken shortly after Lent.
Fasting becomes you.
Won't you sit down, Monsignor?
Oh, yes, oh, thank you. By the way, I was most intrigued the first time I heard your church referred to as the Player's Parish.
Oh, yes, my parishioners refer to my sermon as my monologue. So I go along with them. I tell them, be sure and catch my act on Sunday.
You know, it's our greatest responsibility to get through to the people. Now, you do it by speaking their language.
Well, thank you, sir. Would you care for some tea?
Oh, by all means.
Oh, on second thought, one of my neighbors recently gave me a bottle of Benedictine. Now, I've been saving it for an auspicious occasion such as this, but if you care to join me, we could...
Oh, by all means, Father.
Good.
Excuse me, Monsignor.
I think she hid the bottle when she saw you, sir. That is, she didn't want me to be misunderstood. Now, you see, Monsignor, all these people, well, people like Miss LeMaise's father, you know, of course, how they always give their time and their talents anytime there's an appeal for aid. Well, now they need somebody to go to bat for them. The actor's home provides ample food, ample shelter, but there's a real dire need for substantial funds to provide them with specialized medical attention.
I see. And you think that this charity show you propose is the answer?
Yes, we do.
Oh, it'll be a big help, sir. You see, I plan to recruit leaders of all faiths, get them to join in a great united effort. And, of course, knowing that you're friendly with all these leaders, I thought perhaps you could help to...
Get the show on the road, huh?
Yes, we do.
Well, count me in.
Monsignor.
Thank you.
Father.
Every blessing, Father.
To everyone.
I told you,
knock it off,
Connie.
Aunt Sally. You're the one I want to see. Oh, you're beautiful. I suppose you came over here to give him the rest of my act.
Can you explain this intrusion?
You do the explaining. Variety, right?
Right.
Chez Paris, right?
Mm-hmm.
Jimmy Dugan, veteran comedian, scored a hit in his comeback
to
Chicago. Chez
Paris. Wonderful.
Yes, but I don't see how...
Yes, but one of the girls on the line wrote me that Jimmy Dugan is doing my opening joke and that you gave it to him.
I was just trying to help Jimmy. It never occurred to...
Well, don't be a big man with your friends at my expense, will you? Here's the review. Good luck.
Connie! How dare you behave like that in front of Father and the Monsignor?
Monsignor?
This is Monsignor Stratford.
Monsignor Francis Stratford? Television, right?
Right.
What'd he do, watch on TV and list some of your sermons? Figures.
Tony!
Listen, you probably got some cause for complaint, but that doesn't
say... I pay a lot of loot for my routines.
Well, if it's a matter of paying...
It's a matter of principle. You come around my joint acting holier than thou, and at the same time you steal a bread right out of my mouth.
Steal?
Yeah, steal. The jokes I tell are my personal paid-for property. When somebody takes them, that's stealing.
Tony, you better get out of here.
Don't hold this against me, will you,
Mr.? I'm sorry.
You ought to court-martial him.
He's sick. Tony, you ought to be ashamed. Father Conroy's in there trying to raise money for my father's operation. And you carrying on like that. And to a priest.
Well, just because he's a priest doesn't give him the right to go around stealing jokes.
Oh.
As far as I'm concerned, he's nothing but a Milton Berle with candles.
Hi, Sonny.
Hi. I never could knit.
What's the tea for?
Oh, Tubby. That's his nickname.
Well, what's his real name?
I haven't decided yet.
Well, hasn't he been christened?
They asked too many questions, like, Well, it's almost showtime.
Hey. Just came from my tailor. Class, huh, baby? Real class.
Soignée.
Huh?
Just means class.
Well, how about helping me break
Good
it in tonight?
Good afternoon, Mr. Conroy. Mr. Vincent.
Hiya, Bill. Hey, listen. Bread and butter. How about, look, tonight after the show, we'll give the town a paint job. What do you say, huh?
Not tonight, I...
Wait a minute. Always some kind of stall. What do you do for excitement? Count the lumps in your oatmeal?
Hey, look, I know, you're still sore about me in the pocket, right?
Why'd you be so petty over a joke?
It's a matter of principle, baby.
So is being a gentleman.
Wait a minute. Gentleman? Oh. Mad at me and Ma Pizza for busting in on you, eh?
Hey, come on. Forget about that night. You forgive me for what I did, and I'll forgive you for what you didn't, okay? Come on, look. I know a nice spot. Great atmosphere, an accordion player who's a gas, and food that isn't. Now, what do you say? There's no harm in a little soft lights and sweet music, is it?
Careful, honey. Like it?
Yeah, I like it.
Put out in the lobby, huh?
Yeah, I'd like it a lot better if you did something about it.
Like what?
Like sending a copy to Sammy Lombardi at the Miami Royal.
Miami Royal? Is he kidding?
Look, that says I'm ready for bigger and better things, don't it? Besides, I got a big in with Lombardi. He gave me my first job, a joint crummier in this down in the village. I'm the guy that got him started. And he hasn't forgotten it. Always said when I'm ready, well, I'm ready. Class is starting to tell. Class, pal.
Hey, maybe we are moving up in the world.
Joe, I'm going so high it's going to make your nose bleed. Now, look, get in touch with Lombardi. Tell him I got a whole new act and a girl that's a knockout.
Bleeding already.
Nobody plays straight anymore. You got a cigarette?
Figuring on her going with you, huh?
Sure. Especially when I offer a raise. Kid can use the extra money. We're an old man. Besides, it'll get away from this joint.
And the influence of the priest.
So she'll have me to look out for.
Oh, yeah. You'll be much better for her than he is.
I'm such a bad guy, huh? You can't remember me giving a job to a broken-down songwriter who owned a tab in every bar in his town, can you? You seem to forget I picked you up out of the gutter.
Gutter to you is not up.
Hi, Bill. Bill? You all right?
Yeah. You all right?
Thank you. Tony, you ought to stop Phil's drinking.
Are you kidding? Every time he lays off the hooch, he gets himself all mixed up, suffers delusions of grandeur. The last time he went on the wagon, he goes out and signs a contract with a network to write a spectacular. Then he comes to tell me he's leaving, see? Figures I'm going to be sore. Who's sore? Me? No. I wish him luck. We have a toast. After 15 toasts, I pour him in a cab and send him home. You know what happens? He blows a network contract. 3 days later, he's back with me. Figures, huh?
You're holding Phil back just so he can play the piano for you.
Baby. He doesn't just play piano for me. He writes my special lyrics, routines my act. When we're on the road, he handles the reservations, takes care of my baggage. He lives with me. When I can't sleep, he plays gin with me. Don't you see? He needs me.
You know, and I used to think you were selfish.
Oh, no. Are you kidding? There's too much of that in the world already. Hey, how about me going to church with you, huh?
If they see me bringing you into a church, they might make me a saint.
It's not too late.
Phil.
Is Mr. Vincent in?
Well, good morning, Father.
Good morning.
He's still asleep, but he left a 1 o'clock call. You can wait if you like, Father.
Thank you.
I've wakened him, but his opening dialogue wouldn't be anything you'd want to hear.
Well, I'll wait. Don't let me interrupt anything.
I'm just noodling around.
Like Mr. Vincent's quite an interior decorator.
That's his idea of wallpaper. She's not there, Father.
I didn't think she would be. It's a lovely song you're playing. It used to be quite a hit. I haven't heard it in years.
Old favorite of mine.
It has sort of a special significance for me, too. A girl I used to know in college.
Schoolboy romance?
I married her.
You married her?
To an old roommate of mine. But the song is... It has a happy memory for me.
Thanks, Father. I wrote it.
Balmy breezes are blowing. Each star in the sky is glowing, but I couldn't care less. Lovely night birds are winging and filling the night with singing, but I couldn't care less. Oh, how perfect the setting. But when do I start forgetting I'm alone, where we walked before? For without you near, I must confess, life's an empty dream, of loneliness, and I couldn't care less unless you could care once more. Oh, how perfect the setting, but when do I start forgetting I'm alone? Where we walked before, for without you near, I must confess, life's an empty dream of loneliness, and I couldn't care less unless you could care once more.
What's going on?
I came to see you about that joke. Seems I'm under obligation. I'm indebted to you. According to the laws of the church, I must make restitution. I have to replace your joke. I have some material here. I hope it proves acceptable.
Oh, I can't tell like that. Read them to me. Go ahead. Go on. You're on.
A very funny thing happened to me on the way to the club tonight. A panhandler came up to me and said, "Pardon me, mister, but I'm hungry. All I got in the world is this dime. Will you please take it?" So I said, "If you're hungry, why are you giving me this dime?" And he said, "I'm fasting. I don't want to be tempted."
Hey, that's very funny.
Shut up.
Come on.
Funny thing happened to me on the way to the club tonight.
Get to the joke, will you?
A tourist in the subway turned to another passenger, a native New Yorker, and said, "I'm a stranger in town. I wonder if you could tell me where to get off for Penn Station." The New Yorker said, "That's easy. Just keep your eye on me and get off one station before I do." See, how's he going to know where to get off if it...
I get it.
Well, it's a very funny story.
I get it because I'm sharp, but audiences don't want to think.
You might be underestimating the intelligence of audiences. I think they enjoy subtle jokes.
You tell me my racket.
No, but I've been around some. I've seen the best of them. I know that first joke wasn't so good. It was given to me by Monsignor Dolan. He's a little corny. But the second story,
Look, you and I don't decide whether it's funny or not. An audience does. If you're so stuck on that stale joke, I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put you on at the club tonight and you can tell it there, okay?
You talking about? I can't go on at the club.
Oh, yeah. Well,
but if getting audience approval of this joke will relieve me of my obligation, I can try it out in my congregation at church tonight.
Church?
Yes, you can drop by after your last show.
Church? Church? In the middle of the night? What is that?
I have a regular 2:00 mass.
Maybe I'll see you in church. How do you like that? The padre runs an after-hours spot.
And his master, being angry, handed him over to the torturers until he should pay all that was due to him. So also my heavenly Father will do to you if you do not each forgive your brothers from your hearts. The end of the Holy Gospel. My sermon tonight concerns one of the commandments, love thy neighbor. Now you'll note it doesn't say tolerate thy neighbor or like thy neighbor. It says and means love. I think I can probably best illustrate by relating an incident. Funny thing happened to me on the way to church tonight. I was riding in the subway, and there was a tourist, a gentleman from out of town, standing alongside of a native New Yorker. He said to the native New Yorker, "I wonder if you could tell me where to get off for Penn Station." And the native New Yorker replied, "Just keep your eye on me and get off one station before I do." Ha ha ha!
Good morning.
Every morning. Ham and eggs from room service, and you don't touch them. Why do you order?
Morale. It makes me feel less like an alcoholic. Besides, I had one drink.
That's five drinks.
Yeah, well, the first four may not stay down. Hear this. Today in Hollywood, Reverend Paul Malvern announced that the major studios have pledged the services of top stars, have pledged the services of top stars for the hour and a half spectacular to be produced by the Reverend Father John Conroy of St. Joseph's Parish, New York City.
Phil, what makes you think I'm so interested in his press clippings? Just because he put a few benefits on in a basement, he thinks he's Joe Show Business.
But Father, we've worked out a brand new routine. I can remember when Clancy was big enough for your Saturday night benefits.
Of course, I'm one of Clancy's biggest fans, Cap. But we had to have some big names. That's how we got this network done.
Big names. Who's June January?
Well, she's just an overnight sensation. This record right here sold over 2 million.
Okay, Father.
Honestly, Cap, I'm very unhappy about this.
You're unhappy? Clancy thought he was going to be on television.
I know. It's too bad. Hi, Clancy. Hey, Jim.
Hello, Father. How's the big producer?
Well, I'm not too big now in the animal world, I'll tell you.
Hey, Father, where will I put this?
Well, it's not going to look very good on you. Give it to one of the wardrobe ladies up there, will you? Say, I didn't see you at Mass on Sunday.
Yeah, I had some visitors from out of town. They'd never seen St. Patrick's Cathedral.
St. Pat's, is it? When you're showing off your friends, you forget about poor little me, huh?
Oh, no, I'll take you over there sometime if you can behave yourself. Anyway, it's good to be missed.
I was afraid you were going to be on the outs with me because I had to turn you down for the benefit.
Oh, not me, Father.
Gee, we had to turn down a lot of our friends, Jim. Broke my heart. I hope they don't retaliate when I go back to five acts and a piano player for Saturday night. Oh,
that'd be all right. Hello, Father. Hi, Jim.
Hello, Holly.
Holly.
Father, I brought Sonny over.
Oh, I'll see you right away.
Okay.
Father, the ballet girls were up there for the audition.
Oh, I've had the big producer, though. I'm auditioning dancers for a big production number.
See, I told you'd wind up judging beauty contests.
Sonny. Oh, I left her here a minute ago. Oh, excuse me. Sonny. Sonny. Sonny, where are you going?
I'm sorry, Holly. At the last minute, I just couldn't face up to a priest.
Sure you can. Why not?
The baby's father and I were never married.
Well, innocent babies aren't made to suffer for the misdeeds of their parents. Let me tell you something, Sonny. We don't go to church just to, like a lot of saintly people, to bask in the glory of our virtue. We go to church to repent, seek forgiveness, and to try and amend our lives. Don't you think you're underestimating the extent of the Lord's mercy? Look at this lovely baby he's blessed you with. Come on, we'll go back in now and fill out the card. You have to have your name and your place of birth and your parish.
We don't have a parish.
Oh, you have now. Not as grand as St. Pat's, perhaps, but we have a colorful clientele. Come along. Here are the baptismal instructions and the application card. You fill out the card and bring them here Thursday morning.
Thank you. Thank you, Father Conroy.
Wait outside. I'll be right there, Sonny. Father, you know, Sonny doesn't know anyone well enough to ask him to be the baby's godfather. And Tony's been so nice to her. He's been nicer to her than any of the other girls.
Tony? Really? Hardly think he qualifies.
Oh, he's a member of the faith.
Practicing member?
Well, Phil told me that before his mother passed away last spring, Tony's brother came over and took him to confession.
You know, being a godfather is a big, big responsibility. He has to look after the child's religious upbringing if it's necessary.
Oh, I'm sure he'll do whatever he's supposed to do. A lot of that bad is just put on.
I don't like to judge anyone harshly, but...
If you did accept him, I wouldn't be surprised if he started coming to Mass with me.
Now, whose godmother are you fixing to be?
Well, you do it, Father.
Well, I suppose he must have some character. Mm-hmm. Tell me, how did a fellow like this decide he wanted to be a godfather?
Well, I told you he wasn't a bad fella. Besides, he doesn't know about it yet.
Cha-cha-cha.
There lives a guy named Chico.
Cha-cha-cha.
He drives the local locomotive.
Cha-cha-cha.
A slightly loco locomotive.
Cha-cha-cha.
I don't expect that you'll believe it's true.
Cha-cha.
But down in Puerto Rico, Chico can make his choo-choo.
Cha-cha-cha.
He makes the whistle blow, ooh-hoo.
Cha-cha.
He makes the engine go, choo-choo.
Cha-cha.
The natives say it's so cuckoo.
Cha-cha.
They shout olay. It beats the Santa Fe. Nobody seems to miss click-clack.
Cha-cha.
Because he has that certain knack.
Cha-cha.
When Chico choo-choos down the track.
Cha-cha.
They yell bravo. The B&O's too slow. Ain't a train nowhere that can quite compare to the choo-choo.
Cha-cha-cha.
Book yourself a ride. You'll be satisfied if you do.
Break it up.
Sorry, Tony. My babysitter didn't show up tonight.
Oh, yeah? Anything wrong with the kid?
No, at this age, they just like to be held.
I never got over it. Okay, girls, get changed for the next number, will you? Heavy, come on, move it, move it.
Oh, Phil, hold him while I get changed so he doesn't start him again.
Hold him? No. He'll drop him. I'll hold him. Give him to me.
Thanks, Tony. Oops, here we go. Now, don't cry and be a good boy, Tony.
Tony? What is that, Tony?
That's where he's going to be christened tomorrow. Well, his godmother had the idea.
Oh?
He already had that tea on his sweater for Tubby, so why waste the wool? Here you are.
Well, what's this?
It's the baptismal instructions.
What am I going to do with them?
Study hard.
Study hard? You a godfather?
I shut can't up, will you? Shut up.
That dame must be out of her skull. Stamp me off like I'm poison, then she figures that she's gonna wrap me around her little finger. Or she can get another pigeon to stand up for the bambino. Hey, quiet, kid. Quiet. Nothing personal. Don't get touchy, huh? Hey, I better. Come on, put you back in the basket.
Hit the panic button. Easy, pal. Easy.
Stop bawling. I think the kid digs me, you know? Don't worry, little fella. You're gonna have a godfather. Phil, you stand up for the kid. Go.
I have enough trouble standing up for myself.
Well, I ain't gonna do it. I ain't gonna do it. I got enough problems. Hey, how does Holly know that I'm... Hooty-dooty-dooty. Very, very, very funny. The next time you open your big mouth, just wrap it around a bottle, will you? And don't breathe on the kid. You'll melt him.
That's also very, very funny.
Oh, yeah? Well, the kid thinks it's pretty funny. Dig. Look at that.
Hi, Tony.
Oh, hi. Didn't think I'd show, huh?
Oh, I knew you wouldn't let a baby down.
Just learning the rules to see that my namesake gets a fair shake from the padre. Hiya, Tony.
Tony, you're a good one. Don't start anything with Father. I had to do a lot of vouching to get him to accept you.
Okay, okay.
Come on, let's go in.
Being a godfather is a big responsibility.
Say, Father.
Yeah?
Newspaper guy I know gave me a couple of tickets for the Army Notre Dame game. Here.
Well, if you're sure you don't have any use for them,
I'll... I watch it on TV. I'm the indoor type.
Thank you very much, Anthony.
Well, before you get sentimental, Father, I want you to know I got $100 bet on Army.
Oh, well, then you better take these back and sell them because you'll need the money to pay off when you lose.
Well, maybe you'd like a little action, Father.
Sure.
I'll tell you what I'll do. You're so anxious to get that joke off your conscience that you owe me. Want to make a double or nothing?
All right. If Army wins, I owe you two jokes. Notre Dame wins, you grant me absolution, huh?
Bet?
Bet.
All right, Vedetch. That's Latin.
Bad Latin. Funny thing happened to me on the way to the club tonight. A man fell out of the 80th story of the Empire State Building, and when he hit the ground, a policeman rushed over and said, "What happened?" The man says, "I don't know. I just got here myself."
Hey, that's great, Father.
You like it?
Yeah, it's a gas. And the one about the sunburned fireman, that's great, too.
Oh, you turn your hat around backwards and wear the boots and the big hat.
Yeah, well, we're even.
Thank you. What a relief this is. With this off my chest, now I can get back to being a producer.
Yeah, I read in the papers about all the big stars you got lined up.
Well, so far I've been pretty lucky.
Oh, what do you mean, lucky, Father? It's personality. You could probably talk anyone into going on.
Thanks.
Oh, Sam, thanks for the tickets to the game, too. It was a good game, but I thought the officiating was a little shaky in spots.
You've had enough, Mr. Stanley.
Breakfast?
Yeah. No eggs. Just toast. Poor Joe.
Poor nourishment.
Oh, I got pills for that. Pills for nourishment. Pills for hangovers. Pills to put me to sleep. Pills to keep me awake. I've even got pills to remind me to get more pills.
Some pills are habit forming, you know.
What's the difference? As long as you don't run out of them.
Wouldn't you like to get out of that world you're living in? Rejoin the Earth people again?
Make a comeback as a human being?
Make a comeback as a man with a wonderful God-given talent.
You know, I like you, Father. You're obvious. I like obvious people. Especially when they're so obviously good. Yeah. Came around to save the girl, and now you want to save me? What do you do with all the people you save, Father? You must have trunks full of them.
I might even have a trunk for you, Phil.
No, I'd spoil your record. I've got too much to unlearn. I'm a little too old to still believe in Santa Claus.
That's too bad, Phil, because Santa Claus believes in you.
You're not talking about Santa Claus.
No, neither are you. You think you're going to find what you lost in this bottle here?
Maybe in the next one. I haven't tried all the bottles yet. Maybe I should get the Christmas spirit out. Isn't this the time of year that all little boys and girls suddenly start to behave?
That's not the secret of Christmas, Phil. Mm-mm. You ought to try it sometime. Stop bending your elbow and start bending your knee.
Looking all over for you.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. What's with that?
Huh? Oh. Sonny left the namesake to sit with me, see? She has some shopping to do. Hey, come on. Hey, I've been brushing up on some new routines for Florida. Dig any of the steps?
Yeah, I caught a little of it. She's got some talking to Florida.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I talked to the boss himself.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know the Sam Lombardi that you started out with? Your pal, chum, buddy?
Yeah, I know all about him.
Well, Sammy doesn't want any part of you.
What do you mean? Everything is set.
It's unset.
You're kidding.
I'm not kidding. Sammy changed his mind.
All the jerks. Well, it figures with a guy like that. Now that he's going great, he wants to duck all the guys that knew him when. Just like all the rest of the guys just made. You know, selfish, greedy. He wants everything for himself.
Like his wife?
His wife? What's she got to do with it?
She caught Sammy stepping out on her last night, so she told him all about you.
About me? What about me? Huh? Oh, come on. Are you kidding? Oh, look, she probably got steamed at Sammy, see? So she makes up a routine about me. Look, get him on the phone. Tell him, will you? Come on, go.
How can I convince Sammy when you can't convince me?
Who cares about convincing you, small time? Move!
I know I'm small time, but handling you ain't making me any bigger.
Hey, wait a minute, Joe. Listen, I'm telling you the truth. Honest.
Now, why would Sammy's wife want to pick on you?
To get even with Sammy, because I gave her the brush off. Look, all the time I was working for Sammy, see, she was always camping out in my dressing room, calling me on the phone, coming up to the apartment, but I never touched that line, Dame. Honest, I thought too much of Sammy. Really, Joe, I... One decent thing I've done in my life, and it comes back and kicks me in the face. That's right. I'll show all of them. Give me another big spot, Joey.
Big spot, just like that. Just go out and get a big spot. I can't bring those big operators down to a trap like this. They trade on reputation. They wouldn't even look at anybody working in a joint like this. You know that.
Yeah. I'll get him to watch me. I'll get him to watch me good. You tell him to catch me on the All-Star TV show on the 23rd.
What channel? Tony, you haven't got a chance. I handled Jim Dugan, one of the priest's personal friends, and the priest turned him down. What chance have you got?
Yeah, well, he won't turn me down, and don't you open up your mouth about the Florida deal, you understand? Like everything is set, we open New Year's Eve, you got it?
What about Phil and the girl?
Listen, don't open your mouth to them,
Tony,
you understand?
Tony, relax, take it easy. You're losing yourself, Tony.
Okay, beat it. Will you? Tony. Let this be a lesson to you, will you, kid? Don't ever grow up to be a sucker. I thought it might be you.
What, no pizza?
Pizza? For a guy who just landed a contract at the Miami Royal? Are you kidding?
Well, Tony, that's wonderful.
Yeah? Well, show me how wonderful. We're going to celebrate. Get dressed.
But tonight's our only night off. I have so many things to do, I really can't.
It's the least a wife could do.
Wife?
Sure. Well, you know, practically. Godmother, godfather. What do you say, Mommy? Go on. After my old man died, there was just Mom to take care of me and my big brother Al. I used to wear all his hand-me-down clothes. Yeah, I wasn't so bad. But by the time we were teenagers, I was taller than he was, even though he was older than me. You should have seen me. The sleeves used to hit me right about there. Boy, you couldn't get me to church or even to school after that. I looked like a comic Valentine. Hey, you ever notice? Sometimes I still sing my numbers like this, you know? It's a habit I never got over. Man, that vino really winds a guy up, doesn't it? Mm. I didn't mean to come on with a sob story.
Well, it has a happy ending. You have what you set out for.
Lots of clothes. And girls.
Yeah. But there's still one thing more. You know, when I was standing outside looking in, watching those guys, dancing with their dates, I planned one day that I'd get myself a sensational doll. A real knockout. One with class. You know, Sonia. And some night, I'd take her to the old neighborhood, where all those guys go. And I'd let them watch her and eat their hearts out. That's kind of a crazy idea.
You know old neighborhoods. Maybe that place isn't even there anymore.
You're rented.
Hello, Father.
And how are you?
Fine.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Father. Oh, I have a confession to make, too, Father.
Oh?
I stole an idea for a song.
You stole?
From a friend. It's called The Spirit of Christmas. Excuse me, Father. Force of habit. Look at the happy people. Christmas is in the air. Well, I know the secret of Christmas. A secret I'm willing to share. It's not the glow you feel when snow appears. It's not the Christmas card you've sent for years. Not the joyful sound when sleigh bells ring. Or the merry songs children sing. Well, of course it still needs a lot of work.
Oh, but it's great. You're off to such a good start. I couldn't be more pleased.
Thanks, Father.
How about coming up for a spot of tea, huh?
Oh, I'd like that. Well, have you heard the good news?
There's more good news?
Well, hasn't Holly told you? Tony's been booked in the Miami Royal. We open New Year's Eve.
Oh,
glad to hear it. You're wearing a long face to be glad in.
Well,
don't worry. I'll watch out for him.
So you see, Father, Tony really needs me in the act. Not only does he need me, but Florida would be a wonderful place for Dad to recuperate. Yeah. Don't you think that line about Dad recuperating will win him over?
Well, that's honest. But Father's going to ask you why you're going with him, see?
Why? Because I need a job.
Oh, now, that's not true. Because there are quite a few jobs here in town you could get. So that's no reason at all, at all.
There must be a reason. I'll take over, Mary. Maybe I better sit down for this.
Father, you're not being fair. When Sonny was troubled, you helped her find a way. And that's all Tony wants, a way to get out of his environment. All he ever talks about is class. And that's what this job in Florida means to him, a chance to have class.
If he had any class, he'd leave you alone.
maybe I can't leave him alone, Father.
Suppose he's told you that he loves you.
Well, no, not in so many words, but...
I didn't think there was room enough on that wall for another picture. This is what he'd been building up to then, with the football tickets and the baptism. Where'll I find Tony?
He's at Bradshaw's Clothing.
I saw Sinatra in here the other day getting fitted for a jack. You got any of that jazz?
Right over here, sir. We can make up a handsome jacket for you out of this for $175.
Sinatra paid $200.
It's on sale now.
Well, what do you got to cost $200?
Why don't you wait till the sale's over?
Hiya, Phil. Yeah, well, make one out of this Sinatra material for me, will you? And what about that white jacket? And also the blazer.
I'll check with the tailor.
Well, Father, I see you got your new retread out for an airing. Hey, Phil. Well, you see the jacket I'm having made out of this. Real soigné, man, soigné.
Class, Tony, class.
Hey, Father, you better watch out in here. These guys are liable to fit you for an Ivy League cassock.
I really didn't come here to discuss my wardrobe. What I wanted to talk about is... You wish to be waited on, sir?
Oh, no, no. I like wearing a trunk.
Some fit, huh?
Where does Holly fit?
What do you mean? Fit?
Into your scheme of things.
Well, she fits fine, just fine. She's a nice kid.
I'd like to see her stay that way.
Yeah, well... She works real fine. We get along real great together. We work well together, Father, you know. Hey, Phil, how do you like the lapels? The tailor worked it up, my idea.
You made her fall in love with you, didn't you?
Who are you to interfere with love?
I don't interfere with love. But from what I've seen, your idea of love runs more to wallpaper.
Boy, I knew I was going to have trouble with you from the start. Now, look. I got big news for you. She's going away with me, and nothing you can say or do can stop it. So lay off, will you? Maybe if you play your cards right, I'll have you come down and visit us. Down in Florida. Catch our new act.
Phil tells me there's another girl around that you could use in the act.
Look, Father, you're putting on your own show, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is my show. Let me do the casting.
I might have a casting idea that would interest you.
Nothing you could say would interest me.
Not even the Holiday Review? Big all-star charity show? Featuring some of the greatest names in show business and a nationwide hookup? And... introducing Tony Vincent.
Look, Father, I'm putting on my own show and I'm very busy. I gotta get girls, I gotta get musicians.
You know what exposure like this would do for you? What it would mean? The prestige, the millions of viewers watching? It's a really big class, wouldn't it? Mm-hmm. You give up Holly, I'll put you on the show.
Give up Holly?
That's right, give her up.
Hey, Father. Isn't this kind of dirty pool, the way you're cutting up this girl?
At least she'd be where she belongs.
Well, it's a little more complicated than that. She's a human being, not just another clink in a collection plate.
Oh, Phil, don't you understand? This is just an elaborate plan he's cooked up to put me in a position where I have to put him on the show.
But, Holly, how's she gonna feel? What are you gonna tell her?
I'm gonna tell her the truth. Be rough on her, but not as rough as it might have been.
You got nothing to tell her.
What do you mean? You don't want to go on?
No. I'll think it over. Leave me alone.
You are alone.
Know how much a big career means to Tony, and yet you dangle that big fat opportunity in front of him like 30 pieces of silver.
Well, if we're gonna relate to scripture, let's just say I was trying to deliver someone from evil.
By leading him into temptation?
Next time you say one for me. The next time you pray one for me. And you have my promise, I'll say one for you. The next best thing to one prayer is two. The next time you're wishing, just wish one more. And let's keep a thought for each other. Your brightest star will brighter be if the next time you say one, you kneel down to pray one, you remember to say one for me.
Damn to see anyone going to bed without a pizza. And no strings attached. If this pizza's the least bit stringy, back it goes.
Holly.
And you just relax. We're just gonna eat a pizza.
Look, kid.
What else can you do with a pizza? A little vino, go. good for your resistance. Breaks it down.
Kid, it's kind of late.
You don't want that to get cold.
Holly, don't you think you better go home?
I can't. Not until I get what I came for. The truth. Do I mean anything to you, Tony? Do I? Tony? I'm a gal who always gets what she came for.
Now the second half of the Holiday Review for the benefit of the Actors' Medical Fund.
Hiya, piano player.
Father John Conroy is honored to present a great new star. A young lady, 16 years of age, who was unknown 5 months ago, but who today has risen to the heights with her gold record rendition of The Night Rock and Roll Died. And here she is, Miss June January.
Beats gone Easter, huh?
I recall with affright when I think of the night we were brought to the brink. The same kind of hopsters had come through the door, and the hop was hopping like all the hops before. Now who'd have guessed somewhere about 10:15 the roundest of haircuts would come upon the rhythm was stomping, the trumpets were romping, when from out of the crowd some idiot loudly cried, "Please play me a waltz, play me something with schmaltz." The dancers, they all looked around horrified. The night that rock and roll died.
Yeah, come in. Oh, hi, Father.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't know I was a nervous type, but millions of people looking in. Well, I never had a booking like this.
The Miami Royal was another booking you never had. You must have wanted this awful bad. Good luck, son.
You're on next.
Until they threw him aside. The leader said, "Make a din for me and beat a home that's skin for me, or else this night we're living in for me as the night that rock and roll died." They began to next time you're bashing, look out for that crashing. Shotgun corners this game, and he's got a name like Clyde. I'm warning you, just steer clear. most.
What's the matter? You blind look.
That's what you get going to an expensive tailor.
They sent me the wrong jacket.
Thank you.
I can't go on like this, Bill. Now, come on.
Now, here is his reverence.
I'll get your other jacket.
Conroy of St. Joseph's Parish.
Oh, my.
Thank you, Joe.
This one fits me just great.
Now, our next performer hasn't as yet achieved fame, but we feel confident that his appearance tonight is going to start him in that direction. You know, show business, in its search for talent, leaves no stone unturned. Here he is, then, a young man who has to be seen to be appreciated, Tony Vincent.
My tailor delivered the wrong jacket. However, that doesn't bother me. I've worked in short sleeves before. When Father Conroy introduced me, he said that in searching for talent, they leave no stone unturned. That's where you find a guy like me, under a rock. I crawled out from under one to be here tonight. This show tonight has featured the greatest stars in the business. This is certainly no time or place for untried talent. So, I'd like to use the time allotted to me to present a talent that already has been proven. A few years back, composer Phil Stanley gave us several song hits. Remember, I couldn't care less? That was one of them. Tonight, I'm going to present one of his most recent efforts. And here to sing it is the man who inspired the song, Father Conroy.
And here's my friend, Phil Stanley. Phil, here we are. Why don't you start this and...
Okay.
Maybe the orchestra will join in the chorus.
All right.
And we'll just see what happens.
Okay, Father. You think we can get Tony's tailor to measure him for a trunk?
Why not?
Look at the happy people. Christmas is in the air. Well, I know the secret of Christmas, a secret I'm willing to share. It's not the glow you feel when snow appears. It's not the Christmas card you've sent for years. Not the joyful sound when sleigh bells ring, or the merry songs children sing. The little gift you send on Christmas Day bring back the friend you've turned away. So may I suggest the secret of Christmas is not the things you do at Christmas time, but the Christmas things you do all year through.
Christmas all year through. It's not the glow you feel.
It's not the glow
when snow appears.
It's not the Christmas card you've sent for years
and years.
Not the joyful sound when sleigh bells ring,
or the merry songs children sing.
Sons and children sing.
That little gift you send on Christmas Day will not bring back the friend you've turned away. So may I suggest the secret of Christmas is not the things you do,
not the things you do at Christmas time, but the Christmas things you do.
Going on our honeymoon?
No honeymoon, honey. We're working.
Working?
In Miami. Sammy Lombardi's wife finally broke down and told him the truth. But don't ever tell Father, will you? He gets such a big charge out of forgiving people. Okay?
Okay.